thank you for liking my channel and subscribing to my YouTube channel Creative Crafting. So I am back with another video, and this video is all about TransferMe. Yes, it's a newly launched by Dress My Craft, Crafters Corner India. And I must say, these are like, you know, very quick to do, and I just love those sheets because you can work on all kind of surfaces, porous, non-porous, and you can give a different look to your projects, and you don't need ample of time. If you are in a rush, you have to make some project, you want to give them a different look, just use TransferMe and you are with a new look. So over here I have made quite a few envelopes, but I am just showing you two envelopes using TransferMe sheets. So in this video I'll show you how I made these envelopes. So let's begin. So for this, definitely we will need TransferMe sheets, we'll need distress inks, and we'll don't forget to have a bowl of water, a brush, some tissue paper. So let's begin. Now what I did, this is a normal iris paper, 270 GSM. I have done gesso on top of it. So if you want to know how I did gesso, I have another video where I have shown how to do a gesso on a paper. So I did gesso on this. Now let's begin. Now I am taking distress ink, and you can see how quickly we can make these envelopes. And it looks so good. You can, it's very good for gifting. So I'm taking these small ink cubes because the texture which I'm going to give, we need this one. So what I'll do, I'll just put it, and as you can see, I'm doing it very light hands. It's very light. Just you can say feather touch, and then I'll take Victorian velvet. Yeah, this is hickory smoke. You can take any shades of grey or whichever color you want. There's any combination can be done. So now I'm doing it with Victorian velvet. I just want that look. Why I have used gesso? Because the kind of look I wanted for this, I will not get if I do it on direct paper. I can show you if I use this directly on a piece of paper, how will it look? So I just can't find a cardstock. Let me just check. Yeah. So okay, I'll get it and show it to you. Now again, I'm not satisfied with the gray, so I'm doing it again. So just, you can even use weathered wood to give a more of grayish effect. But I might tell you, if we use our distress inks in this way, the inks get empty very fast. And since I think this is a gesso, the amount of ink goes on the paper is very, controlled. So that is why we are getting this look. And I'm liking this look, and I wanted this look only for my project. So now I have kept this one ready. Now on this, what I'll do, I'll first use TransferMe and then we'll color it. So to begin with, I will take, I think I'll go with this one. I hope you all know how to use this. So first, there is a small film which we need to remove. So let me just try. I hope it comes out easily. Keep trying from different sides. Yeah. So when we remove that film, you can see something sticky like this. So now what I'll do, I'll take the paper, a bowl of water, and I'll dip it inside this. Now I'll just wait. Now don't let it curl. Just keep pressing it so it remains straight, and I think you just need to hardly 10-15 seconds Now I'll just remove it. And I'll transfer this beautiful design on my paper. Now I definitely need a brush, so I'll dip my brush in water and just go over through it so that there is no air bubble, and I make sure that the design is completely stuck to the paper. Now what I do, I take this tissue paper and I press it. Now I'll try to remove it and I'll see whether it's coming out or not. If it's not coming out, I'll again use some water and put it on the back of the paper. Now I'll again try. So I'll try from another side and see if it's coming out. Yeah, it's coming out, as you can see. But I think the film is also coming out, so I'll just put it this way. See, isn't it pretty? It's just wow. Like, however, we thanks Shalini Mittal, Crafters Corner India, Dress My Craft, for coming up with such a beautiful product. It's less. And with festive season around, you know, you can make something quickly. Now what we'll do, we'll just leave it for a little bit to dry, because we need to again ink it up. So by that time, I'll take this one, the one which we have already inked. So for this, I think I can go with a deer one, or maybe I'll use this. The best part is, it don't need to do any fussy cutting also, because it's already it already get removed when you do that transfer. So again, I am trying to take out that protective film, which is very important to be removed, because I already did a mistake. I didn't knew that we have to remove the protective film, and I spoiled one of my paper. So again, I will dip it in the water and I'll just wait for 10 seconds or 15 seconds. I am not letting it curled up, as you can see. I keep pressing it on. So now it's time, I think I should remove it. I'll remove it and I will press it. I'll do it in center only, because I'll see what I can do on sides. Again, I'll use my brush and just go over the paper, so to ensure that there is. Yeah, one more thing, since distress inks reacts with water, so it will react with water, but again, it's okay. We can always color it later. You can even use archival inks, because archival also comes in mini, so you can try. You can try all different inks whichever you have, because I think if you use archival, then it won't react with water and your color will be intact. So now I'll try, if I'll see if it's coming out or not. I'll go very slow. Yes, it's coming out and the magic is happening. As you can see, wow. I'm telling you, if you'll try this, you'll fall in love with this product. These are like very good, very good, amazing product. Now I'm just taking a tissue paper and I'm just going over it. Again, I'll let it dry before doing anything. Always remember to let it dry, because if you can see, there is a plastic film over here, and if you try to do anything while it is wet, it might come out. So it's always better to leave it like that for some time to dry. Now what I'll do, I will color this. So I am not sure which color I will use, but I'll use a random color. And I just get my brush. Yeah. So I think I will go with yellow and gray. Let's try. So you can see the magic. You can work it with in a very different ways. There are some ways you can go in gradient from light to dark, dark to light. So you know, this is the plastic film, I think, where that thing was there. So you can always put glitter or something. Now again, I'm taking a little bit of gray. I am just playing with it. You can try with any colors you want. All will look pretty only. You can even leave it this much. If your client wants something very cheap, you know, you can make it. I don't think so, we took it much time. So you can see, you can even put some glitter over here. You can do some die cuts over here. You can do some stamping. You can do mixed media. You can even do something like corners, which I have done over here. And this is on the center. Now this ink, this and this color, there is a difference. This was inked up heavily and this was inked up a little light. Now I'll show you this one. I have not yet made them into an envelope. This is my favorite one. I just loved it. I used all the four corners. It is from different transforme sheets. Then I put this in our center. You can give this to a beautiful bride. As we know, in India, we all give shagun envelopes. So this kind of thing is something very different. I don't think so anybody will be having this kind of envelopes. And you can just, what I have done, I have put gesso. I took gesso and I have just randomly put gesso. And then I have put a glitter and I heated the gesso. When we heat the gesso, the gesso plumps up a little and it gives us a little different look. So you can see, I have like played in a very different manner. You can make them into envelopes. You can make beautiful tags out of it. Now, if you want, you can again try going over it with the ink. See. So as we can see that even this portion which was not colored is looking a little bit colored. You can try using glitter and many things. So, but this is my favorite thing, like, you know, going quickly over the making the envelope with these small distressings, and we need small distressings for this technique. Now one more thing I can show you, I have already kept it ready. What you can do is you can give a gradient look. So now in this, I am first, whatever was in my brush, I am using that much only. Please excuse my shaky video, I need to fix it. Now you can see, I am not taking any color, which is the color is there on the glass mat. I am using that only. Now what you can do, if you want to show a gradient, excuse me, my finger marks are there. So I'll just take a little bit and I'll go over it. Now again I want a little bit from here, so I'll just go over it. Now what I'll do a transfer me on the center. I don't mind having another yellow one because these are all festive colors. So in India, whenever it comes to envelope, people will like to buy something in red, yellow or festival colors. So we can put this deer, and we can even use these as the corners. So let's try. First, again we'll go with the same step. By the time I'll remove the film and other thing, the background will be little bit dry and ready to use. You can even try with alcohol inks. If you first do gesso and then use alcohol inks, it will give something different. I'll also try to make a video of using with alcohol inks. Again, I'll dip it in, and now I'm dipping it, and I'll just wipe my hands and make sure it doesn't curl up. By the time, I'll just keep them aside. Now I think it is ready to use, so I'll just remove it. I'll place it here and I'll keep this aside. I'll again go over it, and little bit water which will be coming out will definitely react with the distress ink. So I'm dabbing it, and again I don't care, I'll go over the ink side again. Now I'll just wait for a few seconds, or I'll check whether it is coming out. No, it's still not coming out. I think I'll again put a water. So again I'm coating it with a water. Now again I'll try. Still it's not yet done. I'll again use some water. Okay, now it's still not done. Let me just check from the other side. No, the film is also coming out, so I'll just dab it once. I'll again put some water. I will try one with archival inks, and then I will post it on my social media handle, and then you can check it out, because I have archivals in small one also, and for this kind of technique we do need the smaller ones only, because if you rub a big pad, the whole pad will be covered in once and it won't give you those woody kind of effect. So now let's see. Yes, it is coming out. And I'll again just go over it with the tissue paper. Now what I'll do? I'll do the corners. I'll again remove the protective coating film. If you don't remove that film, then you won't get you won't be able to get the desired result. Sorry. Is it coming out? Let me just check it. Yeah. See, even if you can see, this film is also coming out, so I'll just make sure to place it, because this film is very important. This is the film which gets transferred to the paper. Now I am holding this because it's a very small piece, so you can even count like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Sometimes I do that, and whenever we do that counting, I keep reminding myself of how we used to play when as a child, when we used to count like 1, 2, 3, 4. It was fun. Now again, I'll once again go with it. If you let this distressing dry, then I don't think so it will react so much with water, because there is a gesso. Now again, I'm trying to see whether it's coming out or not. Still, I think there is time. I'll again go over with it. So I'll again dab it with my tissue paper. I'll try to pull it and see. It's not yet coming. It's not coming easily because of the gesso. Now I am liking this effect because if you see, oops, yes, because I made a blunder, so I think this has happened. So please be careful while you work with it. But no wonders. This is a beautiful product. If you see, the gesso, the colored part has also come on over here, and it is giving it a very different look. So you can see now I'll put this and it's done. So I hope you all enjoyed it, and if there was any mistake, then I'm really very sorry. I'm a newcomer for YouTube. It's a beginning for me, so please do bear with me. Like and support me. Thank you so much. Bye bye.